We've got something sweet for you in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Discover Newport has brought back Joe Simone from Simone's, and we're making butterscotch pudding. You said this is a very popular recipe.
This, hands down, is the most requested recipe from my restaurant, Simone's, and my old restaurant, the Sunnyside.
Well, so, I'm glad that you're making it today.
Yeah, it's my pleasure to share it. It's so easy and great.
I was going to ask at first, is everything out on the counter, everything that we need?
These are all the ingredients.
Yeah, it's very, very simple
so
to whip
easy.
Together, and maybe we have most of this in our house already.
Pretty much.
All right, so take us through what we need.
So, heavy cream. Cornstarch.
Heavy cream is important.
Heavy whipping cream. Because it makes it unctuous and rich and delicious. If you wanted to use something else, you could, but we like to use heavy cream.
Yeah, why not?
Cornstarch, dark brown sugar, a little salt, vanilla extract, unsalted butter, and then to garnish, we have some whipped cream right here. So notice that this is a gluten-free recipe.
That's a good point to make as well.
Yep.
And you mentioned too, this is something that you can serve in many different ways. You know, you could pudding hot or cold. First of all, a lot of people
Serve it warm. You could serve it warm. And you could also, you could serve it in, you know, you make it, you heat it up, and then you can pour it into any sort of container you want, depending on how you want to serve the dish. Like at your house, you might pour it into a big bowl and then everybody take whatever scoop they want.
Yeah.
If you're having a party, you could pour it into small vessels and garnish them up, and it would be pretty fancy.
Yeah, so. I don't think of pudding for a party, but you're right. If you put it in a cute container, it's great to get a taste of that and go around the dessert table, whatever you need.
And then you can serve a lot of people without getting big portions. You know?
Yeah, that's a great point. All right, gather up what you need. It's not a lot. We're going to get things started in just a bit.
He's good.
Really right, good.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Thanks to Discover Newport. Joe Simone's here from Simone's. Butterscotch pudding is what we're making. And let me tell you, this is the real deal. This isn't like you go to your cabinet, you break out one of those little packets, you open it up, you put it in. This is his grandmother's recipe. He says anybody can make it. We're going to put this together today.
It's so easy. And the recipe is online. So without further ado, we're going to take brown sugar. And this is cornstarch. And a pinch of salt. As much salt as you like, or as little salt as you like. And I'm just gonna use this whisk, and notice how I'm using a silicone whisk instead of a metal whisk.
Yeah, why is that?
Well, because I don't love, this is an aluminum pan, and sometimes the interaction of the metal whisk with the aluminum pan can make things taste weird.
Oh, okay.
And if you don't have a silicone whisk,
don't worry about it.
It's just one of those things. Do you see how I'm just trying to break the lumps up?
Right.
This is key, that you will be rewarded later.
Should they get, off brand new box of brown sugar. Sometimes brown sugar sits around for a while. It gets clumped up. It's hard to break apart because it looks like you really need to break this.
You need to break it apart.
And make it pretty fine.
Yeah, you want to because it just makes it mix easier and it reduces
the amount of clumps and
stuff
in it.
Yeah, and if it clumps and falls down to the bottom, then the brown sugar will melt and could burn, which is a
not what you want to do.
Not really.
Right.
But if you do, you know what? Then you just have toasted butterscotch.
No, that's all right. That's
all right. So look how I'm whisking this together. I added 4 cups of heavy cream. Oops. Keep it in the pan, please. So this we're going to take.
And it's over a very, very low heat. I don't know if you can see the flame underneath there.
I'm going to turn it up. I'm going to turn it up.
Okay.
Just because in the interest of time. But so we're going to cook this and stir it 10, 15 minutes until it comes to a boil. And then we'll proceed. Then and then at the end we add butter and vanilla.
And that's it.
And stir it, and then we pour it into a container and let it cool down.
I love butterscotch pudding. So we're
going
to put that, it's so good. We're going to put that together. Talk about Simone's just a little bit. Back to you. Back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, thanks to Discover Newport. Joe Simone is here from Simone's, and man, oh man. Butterscotch pudding is what he's making for us today. It looks great, smells great too.
Yeah, well, thank you. So since we left, I've been stirring this over medium to low heat. You see how it's gotten nice and
really
thick?
Really smooth.
Yeah.
Yep. So I'm going to add butter.
Now I'm looking at it, and I feel like anytime you make this not from scratch, it is a different color.
Yeah.
It's a lot brighter, and I'm sure that means what you're putting in, but this is the color that it should be making it at home, correct?
Yeah, especially once the vanilla goes in. I think that this will be the color that you're expecting. There we go. Does that look more like the butterscotch color?
A little lighter.
But no, I know what you're saying.
But you know what I mean.
You're thinking of the one out of the box. The one that's in the box is a little darker.
Darker.
Yeah.
Well, they use coloring. It's terrible.
Yeah, no, it's true. Yeah.
But this is the color that you're looking for. And I say that because if you were someone that made it from the box and you were used to that color, don't think that you did it wrong. This is what you're aiming for.
This color, and really, it doesn't take that much longer to make it from scratch.
No, that was
that. The box.
Right.
And we know exactly what ingredients we used. Mm-hmm. And there's nothing phony in here.
Right.
You know?
This is the way to do it. And watching it, it's thickening up as we speak.
Yeah. You know, and look at how it's shiny.
Yeah.
And thick. So what we do at this point, I've turned off the heat.
Okay.
And at this point, it's finished. It just needs to be cooled. You could pour it into a pitcher and then distribute it among, you know, 8 to 10 custard cups and cool it.
Well, that's good to start with it in a pitcher first.
Yeah, makes it easier for the delivery.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can see that we've done these.
Those are nice.
I poured them in a pitcher.
Adorable.
This is
going to
be what you guys are going to taste. And we could probably get about 20 of those
out of
one batch of this.
Perfect a party.
Right, for a party.
Easter, if you're looking for a little treat to have afterwards.
But what we're going to do for the crew here,
get this up, this
thank you,
way.
Will.
Scoop this in. There we go.
Is we're going to pour it like this.
Uh-huh.
And then I think after lunch, everybody from the Rhode Show on Channel 12 will have a little treat.
So should these go right in the fridge?
They can, I'd let them sit out for 15, 20 minutes.
And then you can chill them.
Yep.
Yeah.
I like to serve them with whipped cream on top.
Yeah.
Which we make. Yeah, please
give this a whirl.
It's perfect little size with a tiny little
spoon. It's very creamy. It's got that on top. Nice little spoon on that.
Now, as he's tasting that, Joe, you were saying, we mentioned you could make these for Easter, but if you're someone that likes to go out for Easter, you can accommodate.
Oh, yeah. We're open for Easter. We're serving our brunch menu in the morning until 11, and then from 12 to 6, we're going to be serving a modified version of our dinner menu with some daytime things added onto it.
That's
delicious.
Yes, we're going to have a fun time on Easter.
Fun expected, too, with Newport Restaurant Week.
Newport Restaurant Week.
Mm-hmm.
They do such a great job, and we pick up so many new guests because of it. It's going to be April 1st through 10th this year.
Okay.
So three courses, $35 for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
And then some restaurants are going to be open for lunch, and I think it's three courses for $15. So it's right around the corner, and it's a really great deal.
It really is.
This here, by the way, if you are going to have people over for Easter, you saw how easy it was for Joe to put this together. But I got to tell you, it's delicious. And it really has that true
Butterscotch
taste to it.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah. No, it's really, really good. And with the
what I love, too,
cream
is
on top, even better.
I'm such a picker
when
it comes to especially desserts and a dessert table. You see them all in front of you.
Yeah.
I want to sample everything. And sometimes it's easier to make a smaller commitment to it because you can grab more things to sample.
Let's be honest. Could I sit down and plow through this? Absolutely. But this is probably the better one for me. This is the one I will have. It's delicious. It's really good.
Yeah, I'm glad you like it.
They're easy.
Very good.
And like you said, all they need to do now is just sit and hang out.
Let it chill for a little while and you're good to go.
Yeah.
Throw it in the fridge.
Sounds good to me.
All right. Beautiful. Look at that. Will proved.
Very good.
Butterscotch pudding. You can find that recipe over at roadshow.com.